using smart contracts to eliminate middlemen in cryptocurrency mining.
Okay, thank you very much for the introduction. Thank you all for staying here so late. So I'm Yaron Vellner, I'm from Kyber Network, but I'm going to talk about an earlier work. So this work started as an academic work along with Sloy, who is here, Jason Teutsch from Truebit Foundation, and Pratik. So Pratik, Jason, and Sloy were all from the National University of Singapore. I was in the Hebrew University of Jerusalem, Israel. And at a later stage, after academic research was done, we started a real project called SmartPool, and then Victor Tran also joined the SmartPool team. Basically, SmartPool is a mining pool where a smart contract replaces a pool operator. Okay, so first, some introduction on mining pool and mining in general in cryptocurrencies. So all cryptocurrencies are based on a blockchain, where blockchain is basically chain of blocks. And in order to add a new blockchain to the network, miners have a responsibility and perform some computational task to build new blocks. More formally, all the time miners race to solve some hard computational problem. And the first miner who is able to solve this problem gets to add his new block to the network and is rewarded for that. And after every block is added, the race starts over again, and this is keep going indefinitely. So even more formally, okay, what is the block problem? So there is some constant D, which is the network difficulty, which is adjusting all the time. And we have the previous block data, and now when we want to add new data, when miner wants to add new data, so his role is to find some integer nonce, while when you hash all these parameters, the result of the hash function is smaller than some D. Okay, so we say that a block is valid if it is satisfied this property. Now, on Ethereum, for example, and in Bitcoin, things are even worse. So this big D is adjusted every time, so new blocks could be found on average every 15 or 20 seconds. Sorry. However, every GPU mining rig, if you try to mine independently, will take months or years to find new block. And this is bad because if you're a miner, you want to have some steady income with low variance. So for this reason, miners form some coalitions or form into pools in hope to get steady income. So with mining pools, they share their computational power and they reduce their variance. And this is also good to the network because if we have steady income, more miners will join. And therefore, the security of the network is also increased. Now, in order to reward every pool member, the following procedure is carried. So miners in the mining pool are asked to submit solutions that relax some lower difficulty, namely D, lowercase d. And while a valid block has to have a nonce that satisfies such that the hash function is bigger than, smaller than some uppercase D, so for a valid share, for a mini proof of work, partial proof of work of a miner, it's enough to satisfy that it is smaller than some lowercase d. In particular, every valid block is also a valid share, and on average, if we find D over D such valid shares, then we will also find some block. And then the reward for every such valid share is roughly this lowercase d over uppercase d. And the main thing to take from this formal description is that all this is like very formal and mathematical process, and it's very natural to assume or to try to have it formalized as a smart contract. Going back to the process, so we have the Ethereum network. Some might decide to solo mine, and actually there are solo miners. in Ethereum it's still possible, but the rest will mine with some pool operator, they will submit the shares. If a share is also a real block, so this pool operator will also submit the pool to the network, and all the other solo miners, okay, so in the network I, also the pool operator is a solo miner. All the other solo miners can also submit their full blocks, and eventually the pool operator will pay its members from the full block he found and submitted. Now, all this pooling give rise to very strong centralization. So, both in Bitcoin and Ethereum, and basically in any real blockchain. So in Ethereum, at least in the end of this July, so 80% of the hash power was concentrated with 6 mining pools. And this could give rise to some problems. First and foremost, the censorship problem. So basically the pool operator is the one who decides on which transactions the miner will work on. So he can easily censor, or not in he, but the 6 pool operators that controls 80% of the network can easily decide which transaction are going to be added. In Ethereum, they also decide on the gas limit. They can maybe form a cartel of gas prices. Okay, and there were some evidence, not exactly to malicious behavior of pool operators, but some undesired behavior or some slow response from pool operator. So a couple of months ago, there was, so the foundation asked miners to increase gas limit. Technically, no one opposed to it, but pool operators, for some reason, delayed the increase of the limit. And there were many calls, even for miners, to increase it. But since the pool operator is the one who controls it, there was nothing they could do. So censorship is one issue. Another issue that this is a single point of failure. So if 80% is controlled by 6 pool operator, so it's enough to eclipse or DDoS these 6 pool operators, and Ethereum will lose 80% of its hash power, which means 80% of the security. Pool members have to trust their pool operator to pay them, and maybe in some smaller currencies and tokens. So there were exit scams that were performed by pool operators. And most notably in Bitcoin, so sometimes they delay or prevent protocol upgrades. Famous example was the SegWit saga. So yeah, okay. So pools are good, but centralized pool have their disadvantages. So what can we do? We want to have decentralized pool that it's not controlled by anyone. So in Ethereum we have smart contracts. And pool operator mission is very mathematical and mechanical, so why not replace the pool operator with a smart contract? And then the architecture is that some local client will give the work to the miners. The miners will get the transaction from a local client that runs within their machine. If they find real block, this local client also submit it to the network. And from time to time, for the partial work, they submit shares to the smart contract, which reward them, okay, for their submission. Now, as in standard pools, so the submitted blocks are rewarded. The block reward of the submitted blocks is going to the smart contract. Similarly, as in standard pools, simply the Coinbase address is associated with the smart pool contract. Actually, it is the smart pool contract address. So if we would have that, or we do have it with smart pool, so we get a completely decentralized mining pool with no censorship, depending on the payment scheme, but so it doesn't require any infrastructure or servers, so low cost. All the fees are only Ethereum gas fees. No fees go to the smart contract. And also the payments are automatic and trustless, right? There's no way to steal money or whatever. But on top of that, it also preserves all the good things from the traditional mining pool. So we have low variance. It's fair to everybody. Anyone can join. Everything is anonymous. And also, what is important for smart pool that no security deposits are needed. Okay, you just join and start getting money for your work. So yeah, okay, sure. Let's replace this pool operator with a smart contract. Why not? Sounds very simple. So the idea is very simple, but technically very complicated. In real pools, okay, you basically have to submit a share every minute or so. Ethereum cannot handle such big volume. Even if it could, okay, the gas fees for submitting a share would have been bigger than the share reward, so there's no point submitting every share. So the next naive idea is, okay, let's ask for shares with high difficulty, which in return also have a high reward. But in this case, we are not much better than a standard pool, because then again, we have high variance in the payment. It's not very, very attractive to miners. So in Bitcoin, the decentralized mining pool version for Bitcoin, this is roughly what it does. Okay, so it limits the number of shares to one share per 30 seconds for the entire pool, which is not very not favorable to small miners. So in Bitcoin PT pool, it somehow works because the pool is very small, but obviously it doesn't scale. So this solution is also not great. So what we come up to is a probabilistic sampling algorithm. So the idea is that, let's let miners cheat and submit invalid shares, but as long as they are not expected to gain from it, so who cares? So the idea is that, miners will submit a bulk of 6 or maybe 6 million shares. We will probabilistically sample one of them and check them. But the intuition is, let's consider the case where they submitted six shares out of them, so 33% are invalid. So we sample one share. So with probability of two-thirds, we will sample a good share, and actually, so we will pay them 6 units. But with probability of one-third, we will sample a bad share and we'll pay 0. So overall, the expectation of the payment will be 4. Which is exactly the number of valid shares they have. Okay, so they can cheat, but it's not profitable to them. Let's do probabilistic sampling. And then another difficult problem. Okay, so we can easily detect invalid share. They have invalid proof of work. But what if they submitted a duplication? So this is much harder problem, but eventually, we also tackled this problem and solved it. So we introduced some new data structure that allow testing for sortedness of submitted shares. So we called it augmented Merkle tree, and it allows us to reduce the number of checks from the number of submitted data from log n squared to log n, which put in concrete numbers was 20 units of 32 bytes as opposed to 400 units, which is very significant for the concrete numbers. So this was mostly the academic project, and then we implemented also. So we raised some donations from the public back in 2017, January 2017, and started implementing it. So the architecture is as follows. So we have a smart pool contract on the blockchain, of course, but all of this should reside on the miner's local computer, local machine. So he ran Parity or Get or his favorite client, and then we have this smart pool client that we're in charge of. So Parity gives us transaction to mine. The client assign it to Etherminer or any other favorite miner. And this resides on the mining rigs. So it give it work, in return it gets shares. Once in a while, when we have enough shares to submit, so we commit on these shares to the smart pool contract, so we only give the Merkle root of the shares. And then in return, so the smart pool contract return the index of the share it need to sample. And then in return, okay, so the smart pool client also submit the actual share, the smart pool contract verify the share, and if everything is okay, he gets the reward for all the batch, otherwise he get nothing. Okay, so this is the architecture, and here another very technical implementation detail. So verifying proof of work is also hard in Ethereum, so Ethereum proof of work requires So it is memory hard, so it requires a data set of over 1 gig. So we can obviously not store it on the blockchain. It will cost us hundreds of thousands of dollars, and this data set is changing every 3 days. Fortunately, though, this data set is deterministic. And even more fortunately, out of this data set, in every verification, only 64 elements should be fetched from the data set. So what we did, since everything is deterministic and predictable, we just store the Merkle truth of each pre-computed data set, and we can do it for years to come with very low cost. And now miners that join us already know what is the Merkle root. They can test it. Okay, they don't need to trust us, so this is fine. And now in every proof of work the miner has to do, he need to prove its proof of work to the smart contract. They also attach the 64 elements along with the relevant Merkle pass, and we verify it. So, okay, so this is a real project. We actually deployed it. It was running relatively smoothly for 2 months, around June and July 2017. We found real block on the Ethereum mainnet. The operation cost were very little for the miners. And okay, so on average it was like 2.6% that went to gas fees, but technically it could be as low as they want, as long as they are willing to wait to get their payment. This is still not open to the public, and we had 5 miners out of them, one which was very big. We reached something over 30 gigahash per second. Which was roughly, okay, when we started it was roughly two blocks per day. Difficulty increased much during these months, so we end up with 1 block per day. And the verification cost was something over 2.5 million gas, which is a lot but doable. And recall that, okay, so some of our miners submitted only once per month. The big ones submitted once every few hours. So this is scalable. I mean, we could have handled also, we will handle thousands of miners. Right, so you should only do it one per day, one per week, so there's room for everybody. So again, 2.6 million gas, it's a lot, but it's feasible. Okay, and this is an example for, this is a proof that we actually found blocks. So if you go to this extra data, if you observe it, so you see smart pool, and here is some details on the miner ID, et cetera. So we found over 80 like this. Okay, but why is the project still not alive? So actually we had very big hash power altogether, but most of them was due to one single miner, Aurel, which we are very grateful for his support in testing and such. So setting up our system is very technical and hard process. Okay, not many were either willing or able to do. Okay, and even once after we did it, we find many optimizations that we still have to do on the client, not on the contract side, that should support big mining farms. So, well, as very big mining farm, and we don't have any optimizations for that. So he's now waiting for us to complete the optimizations. Okay, so there's still some work to do before we go live, but not a lot. Okay, so this project is open source, not profit, and we are looking for more people to join us. So in particular, Go developers, but in any case, we have a GitHub. and you're welcome all to fork it, use it, or contribute. Thank you.